Hello, this is Daniel. Everyone's been begging me for a 3 red light or E74 repair video. Unfortunately, you cannot repair the box at home unless you have a BGA welder when it comes to the cracked solder joints. Okay, but I decided to show a alternate method that, if it is not a cracked solder joint, will help you out a lot and will also help out some of the repairmen out there that have no clue as to what the hell they're doing, excuse the language, and hopefully allow them to repair a few boxes without having to do a baloney unplug the fan overheating junk. Alright, now you see these capacitors? I got this turned sideways so that you can see the tops of them. Notice how some of them are kind of bulged up at the top. These capacitors are burned out. Alright? Some you'll see look nice and flat. Some are bulged up. And you can see that if you look really closely. Alright? Now, let's take a look. See how that cap closest to you? All three of them are actually bulged up. Alright? So let's turn this board over down here like this. Alright, now these caps here, not really any way to tell visually, but the rest of these caps, even the small ones, you can. If the caps have bulged up in the tops, then you can tell. These, not so much. Okay, but I want you to take a real close look at the rest of these caps. See how they're bulged up at the top? Really easy to visually see most of these. Alright? But if it's hard to tell, just kind of rub your finger over the top and you'll feel the cap bulge up. Alright? Now watch this. We'll go over here. We're going to check all the caps. Okay. That one's burned out. That one's burned out. That one's burned out. That one's burned out. That one's good. 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 That one's burned out. That one's burned out. That one's burned out. All three of these are burned out. Alright. When you rub your finger over the top, you'll feel a little bump. They should be perfectly flat. Alright. Now, whatever you do, don't reflow the boxes with the power of the box or a heat gun. You'll damage a lot of extra stuff. Not to mention, you know, oh, and another little word about these chips here and here. You don't need heat sinks on them. They don't produce enough heat to damage the solder under it. The only time these things would be damaged is if you're using a heat gun on the box, trying to reflow them. You know, them things rarely ever go bad. Well, that's it for now.